Are we all set?
Yes, Commissioner.
Do you have a motion to reconvene?
Motion.
Motion, Mrs. Mitchell?
Second.
Second, Mrs. Peters, all in favor?
Aye.
Yes.
Motion passed. Pledge allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, roll call.
Ms. Barry?
Here.
Ms. Graves? Mr. Hamilton?
Here.
Ms. Mitchell?
Here.
Ms. Morgan?
Here.
Mr. Peters?
Here.
Mr. Thurber?
Here.
Okay, consider approval of minutes of November 9 meeting, the regular meeting, monthly meeting, of November 22 special meeting. And we have a date change on that, which is keep coming in on January 3rd.
Motion.
Motion, Ms. Mitchell, second, Ms. Morgan, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion here. Public comment, I did not have any.
Ms. Barry, sorry, did you miss the approval of the agenda with the agenda items?
Yep.
Okay, sorry. I have a motion to approve the agenda with the agenda items.
Motion.
Motion, Ms. Mitchell?
Second.
Peters, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion here. Okay, public comment, I didn't get anything on approved comment.
No, I saw nothing and I have nothing on the board.
Nothing, okay, good. Thank you. There's always that time for people who are new to the meeting, public in here, that you can send it approved comment. They will read them ahead of time if they're with the agenda, and we always put out what their public comment guidelines are. And if there's something that is not on the agenda, you can address it or it's in the meeting. Superintendent's report.
Hello, everybody. Let's start with construction update. We actually are happy to report that everything is done in our, in a situation in the intermediate computer lab where there's some end of cleanup construction needed to take place, which had some asbestos that was a concern. It was all abated, it's all been done. We're waiting for our tests to come back negative and everything's good. That'll happen tomorrow and I think we're all set. So everything went really smooth. That happened on Monday. And so that's where we are with that. It happened Monday evening. The students were in the building. That was all done after hours and completed around 11 o'clock. Additionally, we still have a few parts of our building project that are still outstanding. Some people kind of won't laugh, but one of the areas, so one day Mrs. Schultz will have a window in her office. We're hoping that the right size window does arrive someday. It's kind of like a cave in there, so we're working on that. In some of the other areas, we were able to get things like the doors on our counseling offices and proper locks, windows, and those are all taken care of. The new athletic center is also usable at this point. Those are some of the things. We did have a construction meeting today with a few pieces that we need to address and go back and have a look at. We're working with Bass Hatfield to address those. So a notice will go out to Bass Hatfield this week. So one of the things that kind of goes along with the construction update is in regards to our athletic center or where our wrestling room was, the new construction there. It's one of the pieces that we're talking about opening up for our community. Currently, with the circumstances of COVID, as well as some of the things, the finishing touches that are beyond the building project that we feel need to be put into place, we're going to establish a timeline of opening that, which likely will be for our community after we have our protocols in place, which would be the start of the school year next year. We'll be putting some things in place where some staff will help us identify some of the things we need as a school to equipment that we may need to purchase and/or ways to look at the space to make it look a little bit more inviting. And so some of those things we'll be addressing between now and the end of this particular school year. And then, so there's that. I went to a conference the first week in December. It was the Northeast Conference of School Superintendents in Lake Placid. It was a phenomenal conference. It was a great opportunity to network with local superintendents and also talk about some of the things that are happening locally as well as regionally. We actually did get to speak with the Education Commissioner in regards to some of the things that are happening across New York State right now. Found it interesting when we did have our conversation. We were able to ask her questions, very open to questions. It was one of the biggest areas of concern from her was she's trying to get state ed back to normal as well in regards to most people are not working at state ed, most people are working from home, and so it's really important for her to get people back up and working at state ed. So I think that also tells a lot of where we are with the pandemic. I will be talking a little bit further later on in tonight's meeting about a coaching opportunity, not coaching of athletics, but coaching of leadership. I'll talk to you a little bit later about that, but it was a really great opportunity, I think, that our district needs to look into, and I'll be talking about it later in tonight's agenda. And then one of the things that I wanted, it's not on the agenda, but I want to bring it up real quick here, is I'd like to thank Tom Tregan. Tom has been here in our school since the beginning of November. Tom is going to be ending, going off to Florida, lucky him. So I'd like to everyone give Tom a round of applause. I'm also happy to report to everybody that Mrs. Sexton and I talked this afternoon and she will be returning. So she's looking forward, she'll be back in January 3rd. So that's exciting as well. That's pretty much the superintendent's report.
Right. Okay. So superintendent search. Just bear with me as I go down through a few of the things and I made sure I'm done and not. My computer was on a reset today, so I have the paper. The board has started the superintendent search process by releasing a survey to the community on our website and Facebook. Paper copies will be available at the town hall and the two churches. I think we've got some here tonight for the community at the city board meeting. The survey is requesting information from the community and stakeholders on their opinions regarding the traits, experiences, and background that our next superintendent should possess. The survey is anonymous, and we'd like all surveys to be mailed or dropped off or done online by December 31st, 2021. The information gathered will be added to a brochure regarding the candidate's profile, and we're looking for as many community and as well as the community input as well as the stakeholders in the school system, operating community, to guide the board and the committees in the selection process. The ads will begin January 9th with a deadline of February 18th. We welcome community members and parents to volunteer for one of the interview committees. Our district superintendent, Dr. Mark Davey, and his staff will be assisting with the search. A brochure video will be available in mid-January for interested candidates. Our wonderful staff is gathering up some pieces for the video to help Mr. Smith at BOCES and Mrs. Manson. The brochure is almost ready. It's very similar to what we had last year, just giving an overview of what we are as a district, the numbers that we are, and what kind of profile we want from the superintendent. The board will review all of the qualified applicants in March and select candidates to be interviewed and ones to move on to the committees. There'll be four interview committees, as well as the board. The committees are the administration, district level supervisors, and district office personnel, parents and community members, students, and CSDA and PAT, the Peru Association of Teachers. The final three candidates will be interviewed and present, the proofs that they will present at a community forum the week of March 22nd. The board will appoint the successor superintendent at the April 12th regular meeting to begin July 1. So it's important important that we get your input on surveys. The survey, I checked at noon time, the survey was up, it's very easy to use. And anybody can just send in a paper copy, you don't have to have a return address on it. And we'll just keep gathering those in the district office so that we can compile them and have the district profile of the superintendent we want. I do want to mention too that a group of us did go to the Rural Schools Conference on last Friday. Ms. Murphy and Mr. Berry and five other staff members along with myself, and found valuable information from the Mental Health Resource Center in Albany, which is a free resource to us. So there's lots of information that we gathered on that, some items on school safety. And one big piece was on the circles. And we've been doing some things with circles in our school. We hope to expand some of that. Sweethearts and Heroes is a big piece of the circle piece. And it's nice to know that we're moving in the general direction of helping everybody, be it staff, be it students, through the social emotions. So it was a very valuable conference, and anybody who wants to read a good book, it's cheeseburgers, let me see, cheeseburgers.
One
cheeseburger at a time. And it's a very short book. Cheeseburger doesn't mean anything to do with a sandwich. It is the change in behaviors and the grievances and things to look for with students who are having changes in them. The speaker is very dynamic and she gives lots of good advice on that. So I think well worth while. Anything, Mr. Murphy, Mr. Berry?
I thought it was extremely valuable. A lot of things to focus on as we move ahead.
I would concur, and I would say that it's pretty telling to hear from that level Superintendent Vickers, and that the concerns that they have at that level align with the same concerns that our kids did at our strategic planning.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It's time.
Yeah. And our strategic plan, we're grateful that they're kind of guided with our goals too. So thank you.
So tonight we have our administrative reports. I spoke with two other people in our district. Sports. Mr. Irvin's also got something to share with us after Diana. So, it's all good, Diana.
Mr. Sharps, could we do the EAT?
Oh, I'm sorry. We're out of order. It's like,
we're
going our own way. So, EAT, sorry.
Yeah, it's just Christmas time. We want to keep moving.
You're going to like mine.
Okay, so.
I don't have to. You can all hear me, right? Yeah, okay. It's something a little fun. 'Twas the afternoon before vacation when all through the school, not a student was stirring or breaking the rules. The grades were all input into school tool with care in hopes that the school buses would soon be there. The teachers and students were nestled all snug in their room, eagerly awaiting 2 weeks without Zoom. And Mr. Storms in his office and the admins close by were eagerly anticipating no referrals and let out a sigh. When out in the hallway there arose such a clatter, we sprang from our desks to see what was the matter. Out through our rooms to find out who screamed, looked left, then right, and shrugged at our team. When what to our wondering eyes did we see? But a souped up Dodge Durango and six board members filled with glee. And the board president, who seemed very merry, I knew in a moment it must be Bonnie Berry. More rapid than Nighthawks, the Durango came, and she whistled and shouted and called the board by name. Sarah Mitchell, Sarah Graves, Linda Morgan. Oh no, we're not done. Steve Peters, Scott Thurber, and Mark Hamilton. To the primary and intermediate and over to junior high. We've got staff that need to head home for vacation. We must say goodbye. As quick as COVID arrived and as swift as could be, they flew through the halls to wave to my colleagues and me. So up to the clock tower they dashed and then stopped, and then one by one out of the Durango they hopped. And then in the twinkling of the last afternoon sun, they called out our names to wish us well one by one. As I listened for my name with tears in my eyes, down the front of the building, Bonnie seemed to just fly. She was dressed all in purple, from her head to her closed-toed shoes, and we clapped loudly with many ahs and oohs. A bundle of appreciations she had for the job we had done, and told us it was our time to rest and have fun. Her eyes, how they twinkled, and her dimples so merry. Her cheeks were like roses, and her nose like a cherry. She flew back to the Durango as quick as a torpedo. I think she was thirsty. She needed a quick drink of water. All kidding aside, we just want to say, we appreciate the time you dedicate to Peru Central each day. Your dedication, support, and time given helps make our school successful considering the times we are in. It hasn't been easy, we certainly know, but when we work as a team, how nicely it flows. Cooperation, communication, and compromise is key. It seems like Peru is turning back to where it's supposed to be. Each building is special, and we give it our all to each of our students, summer, spring, winter, and fall. We will never give up. We will persevere. We will work together always. You have nothing to fear. As we get ready for the holidays and the countdown begins, we will be rested and recharged and return with a grin. Our wish to you, as our much needed rest is in sight, happy holidays to all, and to all, a good night.
Thank you so much. And we appreciate all of you and all the staff. But, you know, what everyone has gone through, I felt, you know, last year's transition year, this year is recovery year one, I think. I think we might be in recovery year two. But we know you're out there, you're dedicated, and we certainly appreciate it. And if anybody wants a ride.
I was asked to talk a little bit about athletics, and I decided that I could stand here and rattle a whole bunch of stuff off that we've done in the fall. We were very, very busy, inside and out. But I figured I would help to put a little bit of some pictures with what we've been doing. So obviously I'm excited to be here. We had a very busy fall, and we are now ready to the swing of the winter season. To give everyone an overview, we were able to have all levels of sports programs compete this season. This is the first time this has happened since the pandemic. We got to see a small bit in the spring, but there were no competitions beyond sectional play, so there was no regional or state play in the spring. This season, we were able to participate in regional and state play. All schools in New York State were able to do that. All of our sports teams this season completed their schedule at all levels of play. We did have a few teams that had to cancel a game or two because of COVID, but it did not hinder their season in any way. Our varsity football team overcame the biggest hurdle with COVID. They actually had to go into a two-week shutdown, but bounced back and finished their season very strong. So now I'd like to take an opportunity for you to look at every team, how they did, a little recap of how they did in some of our all-star selections and things that happened during the season. So our varsity boys team was very competitive and found themselves with a different team composition this year. This year was our first year that we've merged with Seton Catholic, and it was an amazing experience for all that was said by the coaching staff and our athletes. Our athletes and coaches wanted to thank our four Seton athletes for coming to play at Peru and being an asset to our program. They truly enhanced our soccer team this year, and it was a pleasure to have them. To quote Coach Armstrong, he said, "What a class act those four kids are and their parents." So our all-star teams, our first team was senior Dylan Hogberg and senior Declan Edwards. Our second team was Dominic Falvo and Aiden Pearl, who was one of our seniors for those that joins us. Their overall record I did not put in because I did not receive from Coach Armstrong in time before I submitted today. Our girls varsity soccer, they had a very competitive year in a league that was very strong. The Nighthawk team graduated 10 seniors, so they're going to be rebuilding. They have a lot of holes to fill. One of their season highlights was a comeback win in OT against a very talented NCCS team. Our first team, Hannah Myers. Our second team, Riley Lukens and Mackenzie Brown, with a record of 7-7-1. Hannah Myers was also selected to our fourth team All-State, which is a very impressive honor for her. So varsity swim. This is the first year that we merged with Osable. We've always had a swim program here. This year, with the situation at Plattsburgh State, we've decided to merge with Osable. So merging with our swimmers, we sent many talented swimmers down to Osable along with a fantastic coach to help them. Many school and team records were broken this season. Peru sent three swimmers, to the state meet for the 4-1-1 relay, which was Ashley Russo, Ella Garo, and Alexis Hathaway. The Aussie swim team won the CVAC and Section 7 titles, so we wanted to congratulate all of our crew athletes that were part of that team. Our girls cross country. They had a huge success for our girls team. They have a new coach, Miss Anna Stitt, who is also one of our high school teachers, that was said to bring a breath of fresh air to our girls cross country team. They had many personal best records of a 14-6 season, and they had one all-star and state qualifier, sophomore Ophelia Lango. Our boys cross country team. They had an outstanding season. They had a record of 20-1. They were CVAC team champions, and they missed the Section 7 championship by 2 points. So very, very close. That was where their only loss was, in the sectional final. They were the Rainholm Sportsmanship Award recipients. And our coach, Coach Finlaw, received the Section 7 Coach of the Year. Our All-Stars, Nick Recor, Zach Morgan, Elijah Luderman, Landon Panda, and our state qualifiers were Nick and Zach Morgan. Gymnastics. Our gymnastics teams put together another outstanding season with an undefeated season in the 7th straight CVAC and Section 7 title. We have 4 athletes participating in the state meet in March, Kennedy Byer and Maddie Wickowitz in the all-around, Lauren Prescott on bars, Lily Swires on beam, and our alternate is Kendra Lawless. Our volleyball team. Another successful season for our volleyball team. The overall record was 16-3. And CVAC champions, Section 7 champions, regional finalists. Our All-Stars first team, Mallory Martin and Rachel Medore. Second team, Alyssa Bartholomew. Honorable mention, Alex Lavelle. Rachel Medore was also selected to the 5th team All-State team. Our football cheer. We have a new coach, Josie Hart, which is also our high school nurse, to our program, and she is looking to change the culture of the sport here at Peru. She and a great squad of cheerleaders are paving the way to improve our Peru pride, not only at the games, but in our hallways. With the positive changes she has brought already to the program, we're already seeing a number of athletes double for our competitive winter season. So instantly, we went from 6 cheerleaders. You'll see our small football squad, and our ladies traveled all over with our football team into sectional regional play. And that's the first time we've ever done that. Usually they just cheer at home, and we sent them off to support our teams, our football team in regional and sectional play. And instantly, when the winter season arrived, we had 12 girls instantly sign up for competitive cheer. So that's a huge success and a win for that program. Our football team. Like I said, our football team was the hardest hit with COVID, and they, to me, had the biggest hurdle to come over. They went through preseason, got 2 games in, and got completely shut down for 2 weeks. Basically had to start all over again. They ended up with a record of 7-3, Section 7 champions, and lost a heartbreaker in the regional finals. We had a lot of all-stars for our teams. First team, Zach Hunter, Keegan Smith again. So we got wide receiver and defensive back, tight end Landon Dupree, and Keegan Welsh for defensive line. Second team, quarterback Zach O'Connell, running back Jack Hansen, offensive line Ethan Lawrence, strong safety Zach O'Connell, and outside linebacker Jack Hansen. We also had 2 seniors and honorable mention, Ian Westover and Zach Tyrell. So I also want to take an opportunity to congratulate the teams on these Scholar Athlete Awards. These are the following crew varsity teams that had an overall GPA of 9-year growth. Both our boys and girls cross country, our volleyball team, our girls soccer, and our girls swim. All 7 of our ladies that we sent to Aussable all had individual scholar athletes. And on to winter, as we hear in the background, we're in full swing. Boys basketball, we have all 3 levels, modified JV varsity. Girls basketball, all 3 levels also. Wrestling, all 3 levels with a new coach, Dave Thomas. We have our indoor track. So we have merged with, Aussable has merged with Peru for varsity indoor track. And this year we created a modified practice team that comes to just practice. They do not compete. Our indoor and outdoor track numbers have been very low in the past few years, and we decided that maybe this is an opportunity to give our young kids an introduction to track and what it is, and have an opportunity to learn the events and something to try to continue to grow the program. Our competitive cheer, obviously for varsity. Girls hockey, we're merged with PHS. Boys hockey, we are merged with Saranac. We have a very strong boys and girls bowling team. We will be starting fifth and sixth grade basketball for the new year, along with community wrestling. So that is what our winter preview looks like. Hopefully we continue on the same track as we did in the fall, and we can get everybody in and competing in their seasons. That's what we're doing.
Thank you.
Some musical accompaniment, but I'll start with my end because I just sent three of my singers to sing the national anthem next week. So a little bit of an update on where we are in performing arts here at Peru after about a year and a half, 2 years of nothing but normal. Over in the elementary school, we do have in-person instrumental lessons again, which is a lovely change from where we started with COVID. They're using masks and bell covers. It's a piece of like a mask-like material that goes over the end of the instrument. Extremely challenging to form an embouchure, the part that of your mouth that goes around the instrument, with a mask on, especially for beginners. All of our students over there are beginners. They're working their way through. We got clearance to sing in general music classes, which is a huge, huge step forward. And the music teachers over there are traveling to the general classrooms to allow for counting. I don't know that that's how it's spelled. I'm going to go with it. And we are looking at how we would be able to bring back elementary ensembles, bearing in mind that some of those groups are very large and need to be transported before school, which is a challenge in this day and age. Got a couple of trumpet players for you. You can see the masks and the bell covers on the end of the instruments. Over here, we've been really, really busy. The ensembles recorded performances for our Veterans Day video for the district, and we are working currently on some holiday greeting card performances that will be released next week. We're going caroling over at Valhaven with a positive school environment team, and then with Apple Valley with the National Honor Society. Select Chorus is once again delivering singagrams in the elementary and the high schools, and this year the middle school chorus for the first time will be joining us to deliver singagrams to the middle school classes. These were some snippets of our veterans. Here you'll see the band and orchestra playing together, and off to the right over there is the chorus. Always fun to sing outside. Students have been performing the national anthem at various varsity sporting events, as they are right now. The pep band performed for homecoming this year to much success, even though it was really cold. And then turned around in the next weekend, played at the Oktoberfest, or the weekend before. Somewhere in there, played for the half marathon. In October, we welcomed blues musician Kevin Birch to the high school for some concert performances and a master class with our music students. And we're working on an in-person concert in mid to late January to be held in the gym for spacing purposes. You'll trust me that we're singing the national anthem at various sporting events? I'm going to move on. I'm going to try to move on. Car. Our pet. Thank you.
State was held last month in Plattsburgh High School, and 6 band students were able to attend. We did have a chorus student that made it as well, but unfortunately they changed the schedule time, and she ended up having to work in the evening rehearsal that was held. Then we sent Quinn Atwood is one of 5 percussionists selected from around New York State to Conference Allstate. That's the highest level of ensemble that we audition into in New York State, which is a huge thing. He spent 4 days out in Rochester just a couple of weeks ago performing, practicing, and then performing with that huge concert band. We have Ball County coming up, being held at Shazy. We have 4 high school chorus members, 6 middle school chorus members, and then 9 band students from the middle and senior high who will be attending. Just like Allstate, this will be a live streamed event. There'll be no in-person audience because of the number of students from various schools. And then Solo Festival in May will be held in person and will be held here at Peru again. This weekend in May, where we welcome individual students from Clinton, Franklin, and Essex counties to perform and be adjudicated, and we're looking forward to showing off the district at that point. Separately, Drama Club has been very busy as well. We performed our first in-person inside event in 2 years. It was a musical review entitled All Together Now, and it featured almost 30 students from the junior and senior high, as well as a fully live stream student crew. It was our first hybrid event like that, and it went really well. It was also the first time we did reserved seating for an event in the auditorium. We're gearing up for a musical that will be announced next week. Auditions will take place in January, and we're going up the second weekend in March. And we're looking to do one more show in May, and then the talent show in June outside of the Wolf Event. So here are some pictures from that performance. If you didn't get a chance to see it, we had some great, great talent here at our stage. And they did this in 5 weeks.
I just wanted to add that live stream was great. It was fantastic. I didn't have to leave. It was a bitter cold night, if I remember right. We didn't have to leave here.
Every time we do a live event like that, I sweat bullets the whole time, but it really came off very well. Thanks in great part to the students that we have that are running everything, including a board member's son, who is kind of my right hand through this. Lastly, I'm very, very happy to announce for the first time publicly that Drama Club has spearheaded an effort to get a mascot costume commissioned, designed, and ordered. That has gone through. Drama Club and Varsity Club went in half and half on it. We are looking forward to making that debut hopefully this winter, possibly as soon as the end of January. You'll see an artist mock-up here. But we're looking forward to getting that and having some student actors be able to experience a different type of acting than usual. So that's very exciting. And now we do have a couple of pieces to get you in the holiday spirit as we move on. As the singers have come this way. happy holiday and a happy new year.
Traditional snow day model, and we was that in the event that we go over, everyone's doing the same thing in regards to if you're going over the number of snow days of five, then you would go to remote days. So it was something I did share in my board updates, and we did move forward with letting the families know as well. So everyone has received that update as well. I did reach out to different districts.
And this will be on the web with the changes and go home to parents. Okay, so 15B was adopted revised calendar. Motion?
Motion.
Motion, Mitchell, second, Mr. Thurber. All in favor?
Aye.
So we did the snow day and the delays in the calendar. And now we have 15C. I think there was any, no additions on that or anything? No. 15C, an MOA with the PAC, PAT regarding the technology integration. Do I have a motion?
Motion.
Motion, Mr. Thurber.
Second.
Mr. Peters, all in favor?
Aye.
Motion carried. There was no public comment. So, no executive session needed. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, Happy Holidays, Happy Kwanzaa, whatever anybody has, everybody be safe and so on. And I have a motion to adjourn.
Motion.
Peters, second, Mr. Thurber. And we also have a calendar too in here of our budget developments workshops. And all in favor?
Aye.
Aye, motion carried. Thank you all very much. See you in the new year.